How many of you here got up today morning thinking, I'm going to hit the gym today? Can I have a show of hands? How many of you actually did and will? To be frank, I'm also one of them. Do you know something? I never do at the end of the day. How many of you think when you go past a pizza corner or Domino's pizza and you say, you know what, I'm not going to have this pizza and I'm going to spare myself and have a healthy diet? And how many of you actually do without resisting the temptation? Wow. Give him a round of applause, guys. I think it takes a great deal of effort to tell yourself to do what you want to do. I want to give you a small story of this great saint called Saint Agastya. The saint wanted to perform his early morning pious chores and he went to the lake and he wanted to finish his dutiful prayers to God, and he saw a small caterpillar among the rushes of the leaves. It was trying to come out of that dirt, and that caterpillar, in its ordeal to come out of that completely claustrophobic environment that it was in, was getting into the water. Like how great Saint Agastya is, he saw the small creature. He felt for it. He thought that is trying to lose its life by entering into water. It would drown in the water. So what he did, like all great people do, he used his hands, plunged into the water, and he silently removed the caterpillar out of the water. Caterpillar, like what its traits are, gave him a shock. With that shock, it ran through his nerves and he could no more hold the caterpillar and he left his hand. That caterpillar fell down, got into the water. Looking at them, he could not console himself. He again went on, removed it out of the water. He again held it. Even after knowing it has given him a bite, he didn't want to leave the caterpillar there. He removed it. Again it gave him a shock. Again he got pricked, he left it. Third time, when he was about to put the hand into the water, there was a small boy standing nearby. He was doing his laundry. He looked at the great saint and said, "Hey dear saint, I look that you're every time trying to bring the caterpillar out of the water, and every time you bring the caterpillar out of its water and it's dying, it's giving you a bite and you're leaving it. Don't you think you should actually refrain yourself from saving it?" To this, the great saint replied, "What is the trait of a caterpillar? Its trait is to save itself. To save itself, it is going to bite me. It is going to prick me with its thorn. But what is the character that I have as a human being? My character is to help someone. My character is to care for everybody. My character is to help every small individual on this planet or universe. So I will continue to do the same. When it has the audacity to hold on to its trait of saving itself by discharging its powers to prick me, if it shows its traits, if it shows its behavior and is not ready to let go of his character, why would I, who is human, with God given me so many powers and intelligence and so much of sense around, that I should let go of my character?" This was what I learned from this small story. Every one of us, we have like this someone who is a Agastya, who is trying to bring us up from the drowned stretches of the water to ensure that our lives are better. But how many of us thank that one person in our lives? It may be as simple as your parents, who have given you so much in your life to ensure that whatever position you are in today, It may be as small as someone teaching you alphabets in your school, like your teachers who have taught you what is A, what is B, so that you can talk words today. Forget about words. You're talking sentences and you are motivating people around you. Have you ever thought of it? Have you ever thanked that one person till dawn who has sacrificed even after bearing your thorns, your prick, to ensure that you don't die? I think this is what we lack in our society today. We are all so busy in our phones, like my friend Shamlal said. He said, we need to open up to the window. How many of us do you know that we spend our childhood playing around in the park? Do you know our children what they do today? All they do is what? Temple run? Or at the max, if they want to be very technical savvy, play the 4x4 mathematics wherein 2 into 2 is 4 and 4 into 2 is 8. These are the games that they play. Are they allowed to even play outside? Do you know what they are missing? This is the kind of lives that we are all living. And personally, we all are not grateful. And we are not ensuring that our generations also get what they actually deserve. We are all embroiled in our own thoughts and in our situations and not being thankful for what we have. How many of us thank God for what He has given us today? For whatever we are here. I think each one of us have to do. Caring is what makes us human. So I just want to end the story with this one thought of it in your mind. I had a friend in my engineering who had fought with his sister a day before, and while she was going outside house, she went to him and said, "Bhaiya, I'm leaving for my college." While crossing the road, she met with an accident. A bus mowed her down and he lost her. Even till today, he regrets. He regrets to me saying that I should have taken that opportunity that day and said, "Bye, sister." So we never know when is your last. We never know when it's the time to thank someone. Please do it today. It's now or never. Thank you.